Most people think you have to cut carbs to lower your A1c. That's a myth. In this video, I'm going to show you 5 steps to lower your A1c fast while eating more carbs. I'm Robbie Barbero. I'm living with type 1 diabetes, and my current A1c is 5.5%. I'm the co-author of the New York Times best-selling book, Mastering Diabetes, and I'm a 3-time Ironman triathlete. At Mastering Diabetes, we help you prevent and reverse insulin resistance for long-term health and disease prevention through a low insulin and low inflammation lifestyle. Your hemoglobin A1C and your fasting blood sugar are not the same thing. Fasting blood sugar is just a single snapshot, one moment in time. Your A1C, on the other hand, is a 3-month average of all your blood sugar readings. It tells you how your blood glucose has been behaving day in and day out. Here is a chart that converts A1C percentages into estimated average glucose levels. This makes it easy to understand what those numbers actually mean in your everyday life. The rule of thumb is simple. The higher your A1C, the greater your risk. Between 5.7% and 6.4% fall into the prediabetes range, and 6.5% or higher is diagnosed as type 2 diabetes. Here's the thing. Most healthcare providers don't sound the alarm until your numbers have already reached the diabetic range. But you don't have to wait. You can take steps right now to bring your A1C down before you ever need medication. And even if you're already on meds, these lifestyle changes can help you lower your dose or sometimes even get off them completely. Just to be clear, if any of this advice feels overwhelming, remember, you don't have to be perfect to lower your A1C. Ultimately, you need to start taking steps in the right direction. Even small steps can make a big difference. When I started changing my own habits, it wasn't perfect either, but every small step added up and completely changed my health. We are passionate about helping you find solutions that feel sustainable and will keep your insulin and inflammation low so you can maintain a healthy A1C long term. To show you the stuff I'm about to share with you works, I'm going to share a story from a client. After living with type 2 diabetes for over a decade, Cynthia got a wake-up call. An A1C of 9.9%, fasting blood sugar of 179 milligrams per deciliter, and a weight of 183 pounds. She immediately dove into the Mastering Diabetes book and then joined our group coaching program. In just 5 months, her A1C dropped to 5.6%, fasting glucose to 90 milligrams per deciliter, and her weight to 154 pounds. Her blood pressure normalized from 148 over 96 to 110 over 77. Today, Cynthia craves the foods that heal her, not harm her, and she enjoys the freedom of a truly sustainable lifestyle. This is amazing progress, and it's possible for you too. The very first step to lowering your hemoglobin A1C fast is to cut down your dietary fat. This one change alone can transform your blood sugar. Our goal at Mastering Diabetes is simple. Aim for a maximum of 30 grams of total fat per day. By lowering fat, you make room for the healthy whole carbs your body actually runs best on. We have an entire video training on which foods to eat to help you with this. Just comment the word training below and we'll send you the link. Standard diabetes advice often includes far too much dietary fat, especially saturated fat from foods like meat, butter, and cheese. These foods increase insulin resistance and can spike your blood glucose. By lowering fat and focusing on whole plant foods, you're giving your body the chance to reverse insulin resistance and bring your A1C down naturally. You don't just have to take my word for it. Recent studies confirm this. A 2024 study in Australia followed over 39,000 adults for many years. People who ate the least amount of carbs and the most fat and protein were more likely to get type 2 diabetes than people who ate more carbs. Most of this extra risk came from weight gain, showing that low-carb, high-fat diets can raise the chance of diabetes instead of lowering it. A 2025 narrative review in Nutrition examined dozens of studies on diet and type 2 diabetes and found that plant-based, fiber-rich, low-fat dietary patterns consistently improved HbA1c, insulin sensitivity, and weight control in people with type 2 diabetes. The same review concluded that high intakes of saturated fat, red and processed meat, and ultra-processed foods increase insulin resistance and diabetes risk, while whole food carbohydrates, such as fruits, vegetables, legumes, and whole grains, are protective and lower post-meal glucose. The second step to lower your hemoglobin A1c fast might surprise you. It's not just walking after meals, but activating your calves in a specific way. The soleus muscle deep in your calf can pull glucose from your blood even while you're seated. In a recent pilot study, people with prediabetes did what's called a soleus push-up, raising their heels while their toes stay down. They saw about a 32% reduction in the spike of blood sugar compared to not doing it. That's huge. So if walking after meals isn't always possible, try this. Do seated calf raises for 5 to 10 minutes after eating. Your calves become tiny glucose-burning engines, helping bring your numbers down faster. Try it after your next meal and see how it feels. The third step to lower your hemoglobin A1c fast is to shift your eating window earlier in the day. This isn't about eating less food. It's about eating it at the right time. A 2022 study in Nature Communications tested early time-restricted feeding. This was a randomized controlled trial for 5 weeks. Researchers split 82 participants into three groups. Two groups ate all their meals in an 8-hour window. One group ate early, while the other ate later. A third group ate in a typical manner. Nobody altered their food or exercise routines. Researchers were just testing the time at which people ate food. The results were dramatic. The early eating group saw better insulin sensitivity. They also had lower fasting glucose and less inflammation. Plus, they lost some body fat, all without changing their diet. Here's the takeaway. Have bigger meals for breakfast and lunch. Keep your dinner lighter and earlier. Also, avoid late night snacks. This change can help lower your A1c fast without cutting calories too much. The fourth step to lower your hemoglobin A1c fast is to add amla, also called Indian gooseberries. Amla is one of the most powerful whole food sources of vitamin C and antioxidants in the world. Many studies show that amla can lower blood sugar. It also improves insulin sensitivity and supports healthy cholesterol and triglyceride levels. A 2023 meta-analysis of randomized trials found that amla users had better health results. They showed lower fasting blood sugar, improved cholesterol levels, lower LDL and higher HDL, reduced triglycerides, and decreased inflammation markers compared to non-users. You can enjoy it as a powder, capsule, or juice. Start small and see how you feel. If you're taking blood sugar medication, talk to your healthcare provider first. Combining amla with your meds may drop your blood sugar faster than expected. The fifth step to lower your hemoglobin A1c fast is to get enough sleep. Aim for 7 to 8 hours each night. Poor sleep and high blood sugar go together. High blood sugar can make it harder to sleep, and poor sleep makes your blood sugar go up the next day. It's a vicious cycle. Sleep is like a reset button for your blood sugar. A 2025 study conducted on over 1,300 adults with diabetes found that those who slept under 7 hours had higher A1C levels. Insufficient sleep raises cortisol, a stress hormone that pushes blood sugar up. Over time, high cortisol can increase your HbA1c. The takeaway, make sleep a priority. Turn off screens an hour before bed, keep your room dark and cool, and go to bed at the same time each night. Even a little more good sleep can help lower your A1C. We've just covered 5 powerful ways to lower your A1C fast, but I have a bonus for you. The 6th thing to do is to combine them in the right order so the results can be even bigger. This is exactly what we teach in our free Mastering Diabetes training. In this training, you'll learn how to plan your meals, movement, and daily habits. This helps every cell in your body utilize glucose with maximum efficiency. You can lower your fasting blood sugar and A1C, gain more energy, and reduce medication. You can do this without extreme diets or gimmicks. If you want the step-by-step plan, just comment the word training below and we'll send it right to you. It's 100% free and has already helped thousands of people see dramatic changes, sometimes in just a few days. If this video helped you, go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and share it with someone who is ready to improve their blood sugar. Until next time, keep those carbs high and that A1C low.